flavor, flavor, LifeSavers. Got all of those fruit flavors. And the pineapple and the cherry, too.
Ever hear anyone say no to a LifeSaver?
No! Look at that. Found a pack of LifeSavers. I'll try and paint it later, I guess.
Alright, so we have orange, lemon, lime, cherry, and then lemon again, but we'll just call that pineapple, I guess.
Alright, so we're going to turn this white panel into a painting of LifeSavers. Ta-da!
Paints we'll have today are starting with titanium white, then zinc white, azo red, some Alsarian orange, some medium cadmium yellow. At the top, we have some bright yellow, some titanium buff on the left, some deep gray way at the bottom, a little transparent green hue, some light green hue at the top, a sap green, and sepia transparent there for some undertones, some indigo, Van Dyke brown for the shadows, and piglet. And of course, you don't have to use the same colors, but these are the ones I see when I look at this subject. And of course, for stretching and solvents, we'll start with the walnut oil. And then for the just thinning out of the paint, I usually choose some Gamsol. Alright, and I'm just starting with laying out the composition here. Seeing what I can fit in, and seeing what we'll focus on. And I really like the top of the wrapper. But we'll try and get some good foreshadowing in here too with the LifeSaver candies. And putting in some shadow from right underneath. And just kind of laying out the lines with the sepia. A light sepia transparent. I'm using a really small filbert brush. I just feel it's better to sketch with. And again, just putting a bit more paint on and finding those shadows to really bring out the candies. Once I'm happy with how it's kind of looking with the sketch and the shadows, I'm going to start with my yellow, just so it doesn't blend in with the rest of the colors too much, and it kind of has its own power there. So we'll put in the yellow first, find those places, skip right to the orange, and then do the red too early on, just because red stands out and tends to bleed into other colors. So kind of put this in right away, just again really loosely laying out the shapes, finding those shadows in the red, in the yellow, in the orange. And I use my shirt, my old t-shirt, to just smudge a bit. Even though I really shouldn't do that, but you know, kind of gives me, with my thick paint, kind of got to take some away. So there's not really any rules to painting. You kind of do whatever you want, but find what works. But I like to use a thick layers of paint there. So again, using the red first, just to really lay in that powerful, strong red color. And there for the orange, the shadow underneath, you can see the transparency, the translucent of the candy. It's kind of hard to get, so put in some yellow, put in some Van Dyke brown, and just kind of pushing them back and forth together, trying to blend them to get that transparent effect, but still leaving a thick painterly effect. Toss in the green there. And the way I paint, again, it's really thick, so it's hard to get a transparent look, translucent look with thick paint. So a lot of layering here. And I put a little placement there with the orange for the front yellow candy right in the center hole of it. And dragging in some of the yellows and some of the reds that are hanging around that orange there. And bringing the green from the wrapper down to the shadow next to the orange candy. And continuing with the red, still using as much as possible in most places. The wrapper at the top and the wrapper on the left. But I'm going to switch up my brush to a wider flat brush just to cover in the background a bit. And while I'm doing the table, I guess it's on, I'm shaping in the perspective between the shadow and the candies. Just to lay in the form and then do the shadow of the candies left over in the wrapper there. Which is a fairly strong shadow, so I try and make it as prominent as possible now. I'm trying to make as many of these shadows really pop and stand right now and choose where they go. And while I'm at it, I'll try and use this green. There's not much of this green. And maybe finish in this rest of the table in the bottom here. Kind of shape in those last little bits. The pineapple candy, the bottom red one, and really get that perspective in. And then this was a tricky bit, the top here, the wrapper, to really make it kind of fold over with the shadow, because there wasn't much color going on underneath. It was just mostly the darkness. And again, I'm just playing with the red, bringing it around the panel, and using it first. And it's all kind of generally the same red, because it's, I guess, processed food. And this orange was a little tricky though, because the orange I have wasn't as orangey, so I tried to maybe mix a bit more orange with that piglet too, to make it a bit of its own translucent orange, but still have that deep orange in it. I know I sound funny when I have to say that over and over, but hopefully you know what I mean. And just starting on the logo here and laying in the strong white just so it holds behind the lettering. And then just using really strong colors now around, trying to make things a bit more shaped in. Trying to bring things out and focusing more on that shadow underneath this wrapper to really make it pop and seem like it's coming forward. It's a tricky bit, but got under there and dragged the shadow from the back of it forward too, which was not as deep. I'm also focusing on what the wrapper looks like in the negative space between the two. Always just shaping what's going on, but using color as well. And while I was at it, I might as well have used that same lighting in between for the whole of the lifesaver there, because it's generally the same light, so mix that in there to give the center of that candy. And again, when I was doing one candy, I'd try and do the other one
that was the same color, just so they were similar with all the tones that they'd be using. I wouldn't change it too much. I'm trying to finish this one in the back a little bit, put some highlights in. Just its first round, I guess. But I'll go in there after. Really just trying to do the back candies and bring them forward. And then lay the ones on top in the foreground, slowly. This is a bit of a foreshortening on the red one, but again, trying to get in there. Again, using the green. Again, using the green really thick to get that brightness of the candy in. That's the transparent hue there, just to make it a little transparent. And drag it around, shaping those shadows that are bouncing off in the candy as well as on top. It's looking up. It's all right. All right, we'll start with the logo a bit here. Well, skipped a little forward there. You can see I added some shadows to the whiteness just to follow along with the logo's doing. The only blue that was really in this whole subject was on the wrapper. So I lay it in with the brush, but then I go on top again and kind of drag it around with a knife, because it's and lay it on with the knife because it's not too prominent. You don't want it to that you don't want that blue to really be too noticeable, but you know it's there. And again, I'm not really following what the letters are, but more what the shapes of the letters are and what the shapes are around the letters. Not really writing the fine print, just dabbing in some white. Although on the bottom here, as I shape in the letters, again, I go over with the knife, kind of back and forth between some blue, some white, some grays, and following the shadows as well, not just writing, but painting the letters. And again, just using the red to form in the wrapper and follow that perspective. So trying to make the back here a bit bigger than the front of the wrapper. And really trying to just tap in lightly the logo, not make it too noticeable. And I'm going to just use my knife to kind of flick some paint in there to keep it a bit, not flat on there, but because it's ripped, I'm just going to make it kind of tuck it in there and actually follow the rips of the wrapper, because I think that's important to see some texture right there. And again, do it at the top here and put a bit of the barcode in. That fold of the barcode's important, I found, to really make it seem like that's coming towards you, towards the viewer. And then playing with the light in the back was tricky, kind of throwing in some yellow from the top of the wrapper was yellow, so I put some on the bottom, refracting from the table. And again, just using some dark shadows and just playing with the light, what you see, and with the paint and the colors I had. And then again, really just pushing and pulling that light there. A little dab at the top, take it away though. Still shows a bit, you know. Just see what's working, and then push and pull, push and pull. I'm really focusing on the shadows here because I want that wrapper to really pop forward. So the darks and the lights gotta push that shadow underneath really far back and then have that red really far forward. And for the green, just again using some of that transparent hue and pushing those colors back and forth. Getting the shadow of the front candy on the back candy from the yellow to the green. So you can see there's a bit of yellow in there right above the shadow because it's bouncing off. Again, just shaping these last little bits in while I can still get in there. And I like to use a knife because it gives me a bit more attention to detail and get those shapes in. But the brushes are really good for laying in the color and pushing it too. Again, really using these shadows, skipped a bit there, but I made some round shadows around there to get the form of a candy. And you did the red first, just because the yellow, I liked, although I did say use it first, I'm saving them for last because I find that they might be the ones that will be bouncing the most light off the others. So you'll see some of the highlights, I guess, and some of the refracted light from the other candies in these yellows. So I leave them to the end. Again, I just think of the color before I put it on. So I think, what's the highlight kind of have? And I put it on the palette knife and lay it on there. That was a bit useless, I had to take that out. And again, just finishing up here with some highlights. Tossing them here and there with the brush. Tossing them here and there with the palette knife and then flattening some of them out with the brush, but keeping a little looseness on them. And that little bit right in there was important just to define the candies from the back and the front. It's always important to focus on that negative space to really make things what they are. Saving these yellows for the last bit because again, bouncing that color from the back. So you can see a little bit of the green kind of came through there. A couple little paint strokes did it. And then just throwing some last bit of highlights on the top to really define that last candy. And there we go, just throwing in some yellow, lightly with some green. Making those center holes really, really dark, just so you know that they're donut-shaped candies. And just to finish the little bits off, I'm saving the last bits of these shadows in the front again, kind of defining the perspective in those shapes that really make it look like they're sitting and laying down, and then just popping in these little shards of candy. Just one little blip with the palette knife and then a shadow underneath. I think that's pretty good, just touching up here and there, finding these last bits of shadow and highlights kind of to make things pop more and define things. The shapes are there, but maybe just these little bits here and there to really just make them what they are. Oh, there you go. I'd say that's just about done. So let me know what you guys think. And thanks for joining along on the process here. Leave a comment if you have any suggestions of what to paint. And don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, Explore and Paint. And hopefully I can make some more of these videos later. Thanks, guys.